this young human, strolling too far away from home, from safety. But I know you, and you know of me. I know you've listened to those tapes, the ones that you found in the woods. Perhaps you were looking for survivors, or you were searching for me. It doesn't matter. Just like the salesman, just like Ramira, you are mine now. Your soul and your body belongs to me. You'll no longer walk the world as human. And you will forever regret the mistake you've made. Interesting. It would seem that you have a visitor. One that I cannot take, for I already have. You know what? I'll let you go. Yes, this will make things much more interesting. Goodbye, human. Consider this your warning, as well as your blessing.
There you are. I was looking all over for you when I saw you go into the woods. I didn't know what you were doing. Are you alright? Oh dear. You look exhausted. Come here. I'll bring you back to my cabin. Oh gosh. I'm glad I got here when I did. Lie down on the bed. Get comfy now. I'll get some water. I should light up the fire too. It's cold around this time of year. You weren't even wearing much of anything. I mean, obviously you're wearing some clothes, but not enough. I mean, glad you're okay. You know, people talk about a monster that's out there. I mean, other than, you know, the werewolves and other nastier vampires. It's dangerous. But I'm glad you're still okay. Seems to be burning well. Speaking of which, of being okay and all, how have you been? You look like you've been roughed up a little bit, but I'm just glad I got to you before anything else did. Did anything else get just a few regular scratches, but it's been a good long while since we've last met. Sorry. Usually I've just been busy trying to keep my cover with the other vampires. You know, telling them, yes, I've been keeping tabs on the humans, and no, I'm not making friends with any of them miles away in my own cabin in the woods. But, you know, things have gotten weirder around here, even more so than usual. My friend, he's a hunter of sorts, Dixon. I actually met him when he wanted to kill me. It's a long story, but we're friends now. It happens, I guess. He's been seeing a strange, I guess, fluctuation of more monsters appearing. You know, slime monsters, werewolves, and more of that. Some of them have even started getting closer to the village he lives in, and that's never a good sign. And there's been more disappearances, too. It's scary, and I'd hate to have one of them be you. But you're here still. And I think I'd rather keep it that way. Well, not in my house, that'd be creepy, but I mean, keep you not dead. Yes. You know, I know it was a long time ago, a long time ago for you. For me, it was only a year. Well, I mean, it was a year for all of us, but a year on me is nothing compared to humans. But anyways, I know it was a year ago, but in case I didn't, I'm very sorry for tying you down on a chair against your will and pretending that I wanted to kill you. Because, I mean, I needed to help you, and there were vampires that could have been watching, and they could have had their eyes on you, but if they saw me go for it, they would have thought both, oh, the human's dead, it's done, but they also would have thought, oh, man, Holos, he's good, he's all, and, part of me still wanted to be like them. I still wanted to fit in with them and, you know, have them see me as someone useful. But I don't want that anymore, and I shouldn't have used you as a way of trying to get that done. So, I'm sorry. I know you were thrusted into that situation really fast, but I'll still keep them off of you. In the meantime, on a different note, Dixon has been talking recently about assembling a group of people, and they were gonna go out and, you know, see and investigate and try to put together all these disappearances, because many people say that it's Jack doing it, but it's, you know Jack, right? He's nobody's really seen him and lived, but many say that he has a pumpkin head, and he's the cause of these disappearances, and that he's been kidnapping people for some reason. It's very strange, but Dixon wants to investigate it, and he wants to see if he can find out where Jack is, if it's him or whoever it is. He's really brave, and he told me he wanted me to be a part of that group, and he also said I could invite somebody if I thought they could help. And well, I mean, what were you doing out in the woods? Changes a lot. You realize what this means, right? You were the first person that saw Jack and lived. You, oh my. If I had known, I swear I would've. Exaggerating when I say nobody has run into him and survived. But this also really helps because someone's done it. But why would he run away from me? It's not like I'm very threatening. One time I captured somebody to torture them, I ended up tying them to a pet chair, and then I put pillows on the chair, but that's... This... Dixon may want to talk to you. But for now, you need to rest. You shouldn't have to be getting up and doing a lot. Maybe in a few weeks we can talk to him together. Or if you feel like it'd be better, you can go on your own. It'll be safe during the daytime to get out. Just, I guess tonight you can rest here again. Maybe this will teach you to, you know, stay inside during the night. I'm kidding. Obviously you can go out at night, just not into the woods that is known for brutal murders and disappearances. But I understand what you were trying to do. You had the tapes and all that. Do you still have the tapes? Oh, you could have sworn you did, but they're not with you anymore. That's troubling. Does confirm that Jack may be behind all of this. I mean, it was obvious that he was, but now we have solid proof. Living proof. It's getting very late. Look, I'll keep the fire running, and in the morning, maybe we can go into the village. And we can get breakfast together. I mean, don't worry about me. I always go down there more than you think. I don't really talk to anybody. I just put on a hood, and they don't suspect a thing. I just have to make sure they don't see my teeth. And if they do, I can run down to Dixon, and he'll pretend to kill me. It's rather funny. It's actually happened before. maybe you can see it. It actually works every time. It's funny. But yeah, you get your rest, okay? I'll make sure nothing else happens to you. sleeping is optional for me, so I mean, it feels good to do it, but I don't really necessarily need it, so I can watch you, unless that'd be weird, then I won't watch you sleep. I only will do so with consent. And with the knowledge that I am only protecting you, not being weird. I am a disaster. Yes. So that's the plan. We can head down to the village, get some food, and I guess see where it all goes from there. If you want to see Dixon, then I guess we can head there. But if you just want to lay low, that's also fine. Good night. Sleep well.